Okay, so we are now moving on to the Colosseum, and a little bit of time has passed since I played the previous level, so I might be faffing around for a few minutes trying to remember what all the buttons are. So, I think this is where we learn that Lara Croft is an absolute bitch. Oh wow, is that? Oh, that is skulls. Oh, charming. That's always reassuring, isn't it, when you go into a place and there's skeletons everywhere. Right, there's nothing up here. Is that movable? This is actually quite lovely, actually, because from my point of view playing this, I've just finished playing the last level of Tomb Raider Unfinished Business, so actually this feels like a nice graphical upgrade compared to that. Although that game is rather... Oh, it's just a secret in here. That game is rather nice looking for its time. Now, there is no point to gathering the secrets in this level, not really. I mean, can that go? No. The point of secrets in the other Tomb Raider games is, well, you would find some shotgun shells or you'd find a gun. And obviously, Core got a bit fed up of people going, well, that's really unrealistic because why would there be shotgun shells in a tomb? And so they changed all that, which is really, really annoying because the incentive to find secrets in, you know, older Tomb Raider games is to find stuff that will aid you in playing the game. So now we're collecting gold roses, which, if I remember correctly, is just about unlocking the special features that would give you some information on how awesome Angel of Darkness was going to be. You'll notice a slight laughter in my voice there. I couldn't take saying that sentence seriously at all. Wow, this is actually really nice. Oh, I feel like I'm walking down towards something. Oh yes. Oh shit sticks. Well, that was dramatic. I can't even remember what. Oh shit. Yeah. Oh, hang on a minute, I've just seen a passage there. Wait, I'm going to save because I... Well, actually, the reason I'm going to save is because I want to see... What does it look like when she... What? Did you hear that? It sounded like something was growling just as I jumped. Yeah, I totally just wanted to see what it looks like. There it was again. What it looks like... Why does it take us out to the main menu? God damn it. What it looks like when Lara goes on fire, because yay... So what? Oh my god, what is that? How do I walk? Oh right, okay. Sounds like it might be some kind of wolfy animal type thing or something. But it actually sounds like something some... Oh. It sounds like a voice. Right. Oh, Lara, why do you do these things? So that's open something somewhere. Gosh, that's so lovely. Right, so I guess we're just... What's beneath us? Oh, it's a lion. What weapons do I have? I seem to remember it was throwing us quite a lot of... Yeah. Yeah, because if we're going to deal with a lion... What's my health at? Oh, excellent. Yeah, we're gonna go down there and have to deal with a lion, aren't we? Oh, the disappearing lion. Oh dear, somebody didn't meet with a very good ending. You'd think all those bones would just fall to the ground after the flesh is all gone. God, what morbid thoughts for a Sunday morning. Lovely. This is absolutely a beautiful place to be to crawling through. Mind you, I suppose, I mean, it is a Colosseum. Does that not what stuff happened? Like, lots of people died. Oh, what's that? Oh, don't tell me it's just another pissing. Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, music that's totally not out of place. I think I said this in a previous video, it's very sort of... I think a lot of the music in this is just recycled. Right, what was that? Oh, I hate this menu so much. I mean, the rings work so much better in the PlayStation 1 era games. And when they shifted to this for Last Revelation and Chronicles, it just is so annoying, because if you go the wrong direction you're sifting through so much stuff. Right, gemstone piece. No. Oh god, she can be really harsh sometimes. Fuck me. Gosh, that guy looks positively Japanese. You know, like sort of, I mean, I only got a glimpse of him, but did he not look more like a samurai or something? Right, what's this? Half medipack. Nothing else up here? It has been a while since I watched Gladiator, so I don't know how these guys are supposed to look. A door opens somewhere. That was like where we're meant to go. Let's just have a wander up here first. Oh good, there's okay. Probably could have done that better, but it doesn't tell you on screen where you're. That's weird. Unless it's actually at that bit where my fraps counter is, but two. I suppose we could switch to that, but it's pretty garbage, the wide shot, from what I remember. Well, when I was playing Last Revelation last year, it just... Oh my god. Did I not have one of them already? Oh, maybe I didn't actually. 120. Right, well, we'll stick with the shotgun for now. Right, so was it. Yep. Yeah. I feel a desire to save because I feel like something's gonna happen there. We are underground and we can still hear the bells quite clearly. Oh, music! Ah, now this feels more. Oh dear, this feels ominous. Can I not pick something up there? Oh God. Ah, I keep pressing select, but that's my flare button. Glow sticks, whatever it's meant to be. Right, where?
No.
Oh, Lara. Right, so this needs to come up. So there's that, that's pretty obvious. There's over there as well. Is that looks like something to get back up here if we fall down. Right, okay then. Oh, is this a time thing? Oh, I bet it is. Right, so we have to. Shit. My God, which one's the dash button? Oh, shit. One, six, right, we'll just. Ah! Or maybe I'm freaking out. Maybe it's not timed, but it probably is. Let's face it, this is Tomb Raider. Oh, fuck me. Come on, Lara. Do I have to put the other one in?
No.
Okay. So what do I do then? Because I would have thought that I'd pick that up. There's no other option,
no.
Just a. Do I have to be at a specific angle?
No.
Right, I am confused. Unless there's something else in this room I pick up. Because it does, because it's three quarters, and then you look at that one, and that one's another quarter. You'd
No.
think, but I can't even pick it up. Oh, maybe there's something else in this room I'm missing. I can't pull this up so that it goes higher and higher, can I? Oh, yes! Right, okay. Is that what the timer thing is? It doesn't go all the way. Oh shit, right, okay. Okay. So I'm gonna have to. I'm gonna have to be efficient, oh dear God, no. Come on, Lara. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, fucking arse. Lara, why can't you just reach in? Seriously? It's not that far. What if I just do this and... Oh, shit. Alright, well that's me screwed it up, isn't it? I thought I would maybe run down the steps. Maybe that would be a bit more of an efficient way of doing it. I'm not hearing any... No. See, you can't do it. Right, okay. So if I screw it up, I'm just gonna have to wait. Oh, fuck. Damn it. Oh, fuck. 2, 3. Come on, Lara, come on. Come on, you can do this. Yeah, fuck yeah! Because you couldn't have just reached in for it. Stupid. Right, combine with... Right, gemstone, excellent. Let's save, because I don't want to do that again. Right, okay, we need... I think I knocked a bit of my health out. There we go. Right, so now where? Because this is... Ah, oh right, now it opens. Oh dear. Oh yes, it's time to be a bitch! I wonder if there's any way to avoid that, actually. Please take this moment to admire Lara's arse. I'm sure that camera angle is just a coincidence. Actually, that does look like Lara's magnums, doesn't it? Because they had the blue N on one side and then the red on the other side.
Well, this is my point. I feel you may be better qualified to examine its secret, unless you perished the thought, expired in the fall. Perhaps if you lighten your load a little, it may lessen the impact. The stone you carry?
Wondered when you get to that. Pull me up, and the stone's yours.
And we all leave happily ever after? I think not. give me your word that once you leave the pit, you will not lay a finger on me.
Pierre looks like he's wearing culottes. Which, if you don't know what they're this hideous kind of hybrid of a skirt and trousers. You know, I think they were meant to look like a skirt, but it was actually trousers that you were wearing. Yeah, stone. Here we go. Here's Lara going into bitch mode.
Now, Miss Croft, you gave me your word. Come now, Lara. Lara, you promised.
Yes, because it's not like you've got a gun aimed right at her that you could... Oh, whatever.
Could you find it in your heart to help me up? I appear to be sleeping.
So, Pierre helped her up, but she's not going to help him up. I know he's supposed to be the bad guy, I know he's a douche, but still.
Anyway, busy girl, got to go.
What an absolute bitch. Like that sort of... Unless... You can hear, can't you? Yes! You hear him hit the ground and everything. Oh, God, and we've got to have the kind of... 80s Schwarzenegger film with the witty, let's just save so that I don't have to look watch that again, with a witty comment at the end. That is an absolute bitch move on her part though, isn't it? Right, I wonder what's over there. I mean, we're obviously meant to go the other way. Well, let's just see what's up here. But that is an absolute bitch thing to do, you know, like somebody is potentially about to fall to their death and she doesn't help them. I mean, oh shit. Well, that's what you get, Lara. And to think her friends are actually sitting around a fire discussing this is, oh, here's one of our adventures. And yes, this is something our friend did, which was just let somebody fall to their death. Oh, is this just that room? Oh, it is, isn't it? Yeah, it is, right, okay, that's cool. That's cool. You're really not in any kind of but this is how Lara was hanging anyway, so surely she should have been able to get up anyway. Or whatever. But you cannot blame Pierre, can you? You can't blame him for, you know, just opening fire when, oh, it's daytime. Whenever he sees Lara in Tomb Raider 1, because, you know, she probably caused him a lot of injury. I mean, you can argue that it's, you know, like, technically she didn't do anything, but, you know, sometimes you're culpable because of your inactions. Oh shit, what the fuck's going on here? Right, okay, so what... Oh, is there a platform back there to the left that's still intact, so I need to backflip? That is nice, though. It's daytime now. I like it when you get that feeling of progress. Wow. Holy shit, I don't remember this. I mean, that's garbage compared to today's standards, but I bet back in the day that was pretty damned impressive to be able to look out and see that. Yeah, I like that. The sky's still rubbish, but still. Yes, that's pretty impressive for its time. Right, so what am I doing? Am I maybe twirling and doing a running jump, I think? No. Oh, it's the... Right, why is she not setting on fire? There we go. So yeah, there's a platform underneath. Right, so... Right, so there's a lot of shimmy, crevassy things. Alright, so we need to get to that underneath. So... Nope, that's not how you do it. Oh crap. So, okay, that's obviously too far to fall to grab the ledge. Yeah, right, okay, so then we have to do a lot of shimming around corners. shimmying. Right. So. Anything in here? Oh, no, to the side. Oh, god damn it. Oh dear, that's no. Oh no, 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 no. Oh, oh god. Oh god, I keep forgetting what buttons are what. Right, okay, we've only got two shots here. Oh my god! Right, wait a minute, wait a minute. Right, okay, that. I did the trick. Oh, God, I was totally unprepared for that. What are we in medieval England now? That's what it looks like. Mind you, this is the same company that put a Thor room in Greece. So. Right, so I think these doors look like they can be pushed, do they? Or maybe they can't. Can one of them be pushed? They're slightly different colours. They look like oh no, wait a minute. What's this? That's a keyhole. We do not have a key. I don't suppose that son of a bitch dropped one, did he? Oh, he did! His body and everything he was wearing disappeared, but the key remained. Huzzah! Oh no, not another bloody statue! And oh god, the frame rate's gone crazy. Oh wonderful, he's coming to life one frame at a time. I'm sure that would have been really impressive. Hang on a minute, I'm going to turn the recording off for just a second. Wonderful. Wonderful. Wait a minute, I've got my... Oh god, if ever there was a time we would actually want... Oh, I don't know. I don't even know how I beat the last one, because it just seemed to keep firing at him and eventually something happened. No, Lara, how about we not, yeah, I guess. What is this? I mean... Oh yes, he already does have some disintegration in his legs there. So do I just keep at him? I genuinely do not know what the logic is in this, and I don't seem to be able to get behind him because he seems to... Oh yes, yes, his arm's gone. Right, so it really is just a case of keep firing at him. Yeah, right, okay, cool. Cool. And somehow the door magically knows when he's down. Okay. He didn't drop anything, no. Let's I thought I had a couple of big medipacks, or maybe not. Ah, what's this? Oh, it's another key. This is our homage to Tomb Raider 2. Oh yeah, there's the other keyhole. There's nothing else in this room, is there? Just more views. Gosh, no matter where you go, there those bells are. At least the keyholes are actually normal size this time. I mean, the actual holes, and they're not, you know, like the size of Lara's torso. Alright, well this doesn't look at all dodgy. Save. Oh, wait a minute. And it's not collapsing on us this time. There we go, and all we had to do was fuck over Pierre and Larson to get that.
And so ended the first of many.
That's lovely.
I'm sure Miss Croft would be the first to apologize for her not entirely courteous behavior regarding some of the more delicate religious artifacts, Father Patrick.
No need to. Oh, God, I think her not entirely courteous behavior of Pierre and Larson.
Unfortunately, the church was about sending a bulletproof envoy to retrieve them.
Ah, but she recognized her place in the great scheme. Some things, as history has illustrated, best left to their slumber.
Uh-huh.
I speak in riddles. I talk of the stricken wolf ship.
Ah, the U-boat episode. Miss Croft would never enlighten me as to the details. For my own protection, she would often stress.
Yes, I'm sure.
Indeed, Winston. And for this, you should be grateful. Deep in the bowels of their vessels lay one of the most powerful artifacts in all Christendom. An artifact which, when wielded at the vanguard of an army, would make that army invincible.
The Spear of Destiny.
But the boat never reached the Fatherland with its precious cargo. It disappeared from radar 3 weeks into the journey.
Oh snap, that doesn't look particularly good. I do like the sort of, you know, that kind of Indiana Jones thing of it being like sort of in the 30s and 40s. With, you know, the backdrop of the war, but then there's this kind of supernatural weirdness going on. This does actually have this feel to it that, you know, it's, you know, we're dealing with foreign powers that are meddling in things you couldn't possibly understand.
Nyalitsa port, once the pride of the Russian fleet. Ex-KGB, the majority.
But we'll see if that's actually the case, because, you know, like, once again, I should emphasize, I remember very little about what actually happens in this game.
Yes, I would prefer this also.
Okay, yes, I would prefer this also. Who wrote that line of dialogue?
There's something you're not telling me.
Ah, yes.
I'm a big girl now. Hit me with the bad news.
It is bad news. The Admiral's allegiance has been bought, and under his command, a nuclear submarine. It's housed in one of the dockyards.
Well done. Nuclear submarine. Sounds nice. Perfect holiday.
Lara, wait. Take this tracking device.
What's this? You're not worried about me.
Yes, somebody has to.
Touching, but don't wait up.
Lara, I get going into ancient tombs, but going onto Russian submarines just because there's something you want. I mean, really? I will say, actually, Chronicles is doing a much nicer job of tying together the modern levels and the historical ones, or like the sort of more historical, sort of traditionally Tomb Raider-y settings. It's doing it a lot better than Tomb Raider 3 did, because Tomb Raider 3 was just like, surprise, you're in a different location now. Whereas this, you've got like going back into the present time, people finishing up their story and then moving on to the next one and transitioning into that. So it actually does work a lot better than Tomb Raider 3 did. I'll give it that. So that's us done with the Rome stuff. And next time when we come back, we'll get started on the Russian levels.